United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see, by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
All right.
My name's Jim Robinson. I'm president and CEO of a nonprofit organization here in the state of Ohio called Combat Outpost Robinson. We've been sponsors of this show ever since its inception 5 years ago. Jody and Pam come to me and was looking for a veterans organization to help out in James's name. We were honored to step up and do that, and that will continue to go on, I can assure you that. Since then, Jody has become one of our board members, and we thank the world of her. She keeps us in line. She's our treasurer. She's our event coordinator. And she just does a wonderful job. A little bit about the organization. I'm also a Gold Star father. I lost my oldest son in Afghanistan in 2010. And that's the whole reason that our organization came to be. I kept in touch with a lot of the guys that he served with in Afghanistan and Iraq. I saw the struggles that they were going through when they got out of the service and came home. Some of them turned to alcohol and drugs. They had problems keeping a wife, problems keeping a job. Some of them ended up on the wrong side of the law. So I wanted to do something to help the ones that do make it home. So that's the whole reason our organization got started. It's my way of paying it forward for him. We do a lot of recreational therapies, hunting, fishing, skydiving, anything you want to do, we'll make it happen. We do an annual riverboat cruise down on the Ohio River on a paddle boat every year. Take about 100 veterans every year. It's a Sunday brunch cruise. You guys got the boat to yourself. It's a way to get away from the kids and get away from your job and stress and what have you. We also do a special event every year for female veterans. Okay, this was started by another board member that is no longer with us. We lost her to a motorcycle accident here just not too long ago. So we were going to continue that on as well in her memory. But the female veteran event is for female veterans that suffer not only from PTSD, but also from military sexual trauma. And so it's a day of pampering. They get their hair done, their nails done, their makeup. You get to put on, some old vintage clothing and stuff, have their pictures taken by a professional photographer with World War II vintage airplanes. And then at the end of the day, they get to go up and fly in those planes. So it's just our way of saying thanks, and we're here for you.
might slip dead in. And coming off the line when the light turns green, blows you, blows them out of the water like you never seen. I get pushed out of shape and it's hard to steer. When I get rubber in an all four gears, she's my little loose coupe. You don't know what I got.
My grandson is Holt Ward, and he's from Washington Courthouse, Ohio. And he went into spatial service training 5 years ago. And he became a medic first, and now he's a ranger, an airman, and a Green Beret. And right now, he is going to be serving over in Southern Europe.
We are the Dayton Vet Center. We are part of the Dayton VA, but where we're separate is we do mental health counseling. We don't do nothing medical. We do individual, group, and family counseling. It's free of charge, and it's confidential and not put in your permanent record until you want it put in your record. We don't require a diagnosis or a service connection to be seen. We're just here to help veterans that need to talk to somebody about what they've been through in the military.
You're a veteran yourself?
Yep, I spent 21 years on active duty Army and have a daughter that's a lieutenant in the reserves now.